this year's Youth Sunday theme is the Fountain of Blessings. And throughout my many years here, I found my own fountain of blessings within this church. So this morning, I'd like to take a few minutes to share a few of those experiences with you. Starting at Strikers, where I enjoyed countless Edgar Allan Poe's, and for those who may not know, that's when we poured all of the drinks together. And where I swear we could have played the game Betrayal a million times with the best story narrator there ever was. Yep, you guessed it, Mr. Lance Roper. From there, I moved right on up into junior highs, and I got to go on some of my first youth trips. One of my first and most memorable youth trips was the one to Cross Missions in Charlotte, North Carolina. During this week, I was introduced to concepts that I'd never before really given much thought, like homelessness and poverty. This trip was a blessing in my life because it sparked an interest in mission work and in giving my time and efforts towards helping people like those I met in Charlotte. Finally, I reached my time in senior highs, and starting in senior highs was a bit scary for me at first. Throughout middle school, I was that one quiet girl that just kind of kept to herself, and for me, entering a group with all the big kids, I was totally lost. But then came my first trip to Montreat. I had no idea what to expect, and I was totally freaked out until I realized that there was one other person on that trip that was just as freaked out as I was. And that person was Elizabeth Dillon. Oddly enough, our shared concerns turned out to be a blessing in disguise, because on that trip, I ended up gaining one of the best friends I've ever had. Montreat, in and of itself, has been one of the biggest blessings in my life. I've met so many amazing people over the past 3 years. Some that I actually still talk to almost every day, and one that I actually hope to reconnect with at Clemson next year. However, one of my greatest Montreat experiences happened within our own SVPC youth group. During my freshman year trip, all the youth decided to do something very special. We crawled out of our bed at around 4 a.m. and hopped on the bus and drove over to the Lookout Mountain Trail. And let me tell you, getting out of bed that morning was not easy. The only person on that trip, oddly enough, that was not ready on time was none other than Kevin. After several failed attempts to wake him up, it was decided that I was the one that was least likely to get yelled at if we knocked on his door again. So I crept up to the door as everyone stared at me, and I knocked softly, only to receive a very irritated "What?" from the other side of the door. Everyone's jaws dropped, and I just kind of cowered away. And he claims that he doesn't remember that, but trust me, we never let him live it down. And actually, I got a text from him this morning, and he wanted to make sure everybody knew that I was offered up like a lamb for slaughter. But anyway, since that was probably the second time I hiked that trail, it wasn't an easy climb for me. Luckily, my older brother David, who was a senior at the time, was right there with me. And while I knew he probably wanted to charge ahead of his slow-moving little sister, he stayed with me the whole time. He wanted to make sure that I was able to see the beauty of this incredible place like he did, and I thank you for that. When we finally reached the end of the hike, we all watched in awe as the sun rose over the vast mountain range. I truly felt God's presence that morning, and that is not something I'll soon forget. I could easily stand up here all day and tell you story after story of the wonderful blessings that I've been given in this church. However, I'd like to take a few minutes to look at some scripture. I selected a verse for you all. It's from the book of Isaiah, chapter 58, verse 11. And it reads, "The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land. He will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail." Now, when you think about the literal definition of a fountain, it's a piece of architecture that produces a continuous flow of water. Applying this to my faith, SVPC has been my fountain of blessings, my never-ending source of love and support. And as I go out into the world, and as we go out into the world, we as believers are called to be fountains. Fountains of his love, and of his light, and of his many blessings everywhere we go. Thank you all for showing me the power of Jesus' love. I can say without hesitation that I would not be who I am today without the love and support of my family, this youth group, and this congregation. The time we've shared here together with